We want to complete the table using the function rule f of x equals 3x minus 2. So x is our input, and f of x would be the output, or the second column. So for a given x equals negative 1, we're going to substitute negative 1 for x to determine the function value. So we would have 3 times negative 1 minus 2. This would be negative 3 minus 2, that's negative 5. So this means that f of negative 1 is equal to negative 5. So negative 1 is the input, and negative 5 is the output. I think it's also important to recognize that this represents a point that would be on the graph of our function. If f of negative 1 is equal to negative 5, the function would contain the point with an x-coordinate of negative 1 and a y-coordinate of negative 5. Remember, f of x is equal to y. Next, we have x equals 0, so our function value would be 3 times 0 minus 2. It's going to be negative 2. So this tells us that f of 0 is equal to negative 2, and that the graph of the function would contain the point 0, negative 2. When x is equal to 1, the function value would be 3 times 1 minus 2. This is 3 minus 2, so that's equal to 1. So we have f of 1 equals 1. So the graph of the function would contain the point 1, 1. And x is 2, we have 3 times 2 minus 2. So 6 minus 2, that's 4. So f of 2 is equal to 4, which means the graph of the function would contain the point 2, 4. And the last input is x equals 3. So we'd have 3 times 3 minus 2. 9 minus 2 is 7. So f of 3 is equal to 7, which means the graph of our function would contain the point 3, 7. So you can see that to evaluate a function, we're really just performing substitution using the given input. But I think it's also important to understand the notation here in blue, and that graphically it represents a point on the graph here in red.